What's going on, guys? Welcome to today's video. Today's video is long overdue because we're gonna do an update on the aerated pasture, which I should have done probably about 2 weeks ago, but things have been pretty crazy here lately, and the weather was bad, but now things have settled down. The weather's good, so we're gonna run out there and see what's going on. So just looking up here around the barn, you can see how tall the weeds are getting. That's a pretty good sign, because that is telling me that the winter grasses at least are coming out of the dormant stages and they're starting to do something. So this update, we might actually see some sort of a noticeable change. I honestly haven't been out there yet to check things out, so let's go do it. Well, the sun is pretty low, so I know that kind of screws up the filming. You guys should, as you look this way, things should look pretty good, but if I turn you around, it's gonna be pretty tough to see. Anyway, let's get into this. So right here, this is a pretty tall patch, and this looks like it's mostly winter ryegrass and a couple of undesirables that they will probably eat. But not actually, a lot of these weeds are what we were just spraying for in the hayfield. Now, tall as that grass is, I can't really call that any kind of a victory, because that's not a treated area. That's actually off to the side. And I think the reason why it's tall there is because that is a spot that the irrigation water can't get to in the summertime. So you don't really have any summer grasses growing there, but what you end up having is that the winter grasses are able to grow there because there's nothing to compete with them. So this first check is untreated. The second check is treated. Now, it could be wishful thinking, but I'm seeing some pretty decent growth out here, as a matter of fact. I can see a lot of places here, I think you guys can see that, where I fed hay in the fall. And I think we talked about this in the last video. Wherever you feed hay in the fall, you put out a lot of seeds and then you get some sprouts in the spring. So that's a lot of what I'm seeing here as far as the growth, but I mean, the growth is pretty darn good. So this angle might give you a little bit better idea of what we're talking about. This grass here, this is a good, I'd say 10 inches tall. And a lot of this other stuff in here is good. I'd say most of this is between 3 and 10 inches tall, which I'm really happy with.
Dog's gonna eat up all my yield.
So again, I don't know that I can attribute that to the aerator because it's so patchy. You know, you have a tall spot here, tall spot there. I would think if that was brought on by the aerator, you know, the whole treatment area would be tall like that. So I don't know, we're gonna keep walking around, just kind of see what we can see. So probably the best part about filming these update videos is getting down on my hands and knees so I can talk to the camera, but I have to do that because what we're talking about is down here on the ground. So something that I've noticed as I've been walking around out here is I see these old, I don't know if you want to call them clods or clumps or whatever, but it's what the aerator pulled up as it went through the field. Now, when we first did this treatment, or with just a fancy way of saying when we aerated it, these clods were all loose, and you notice I had to rip this one up out of the ground. So the point of this is that the, if you want to call it this, the damage that the aerator did to the ground is already starting to fix itself. So I would say after another couple good rains and some time goes by, that this ground will be, you probably won't even be able to tell that we ever had an aerator out here. All All right, so I've got the camera set up here in an untreated check, and it's kind of just more of the same, honestly. Over here, we've got next to no growth happening, and then right next to it, we've got this green patch. And I'm not sure what this is about here. This, I think it looks like kind of a high spot, kind of like what I was talking about over there, where the irrigation water probably doesn't get it in the summertime, which allows the cool season grasses to really take over in the cool season. But I have to say,
and I'm basing this purely off of just visual observation, that this untreated check, while not a huge difference, the grass does seem to be a little bit shorter here. It could just be, you know, it could be all in my head, wishful thinking. But see, like even here, we're in a treated check now. This is by no means tall. I mean, this isn't nothing like that, but it's, I don't even know what the word for it is. It seems a little more lush and a little more dense what is here. So yield, tonnage, probably not a huge difference, but I'm thinking that what I'm seeing, what I'm observing now is kind of maybe a hint at what's about to happen out here. You know, it's still, time you guys see this, it'll be February 1st, but I'm filming this on January 31st. So despite how nice the weather is out here, it is still winter. And I wouldn't expect this grass to really take off in January anyway. I would expect a little bit of growth in February, but really March is when we should really be able to see if something's happening out here. So another thing that I'm noticing out here, and I think it shows up on camera pretty good, is that I have got a lot of last year's manure out here still. And I was thinking about that when I was running the aerator. And what I will try to do next year is either pull some harrows behind the aerator or a ring roller or something to scatter this manure, break it up, you know, and just kind of help incorporate it. I think that would help a lot, but that will be another video series for another year. Now, as we kind of look around out here, you see all the brighter green that is basically seeded from the hay. So I know I've mentioned that a few times, but the reason I'm bringing it up again is because it, from what I'm seeing out here, it kind of suggests that, and I've seen people do this, it might not be a bad idea to put a little seed spreader on the back of the aerator, and as you aerate, maybe just throw out, you know, a very light rate. I wouldn't say a full rate, but maybe throw out some ryegrass or, you know, some sort of winter grass seed while I'm aerating at, you know, 30 pounds of the acre, 20 pounds of the acre, you know, just real light. But, you know, just enough to kind of stimulate some growth in the spring. And I might be able to turn yearlings out here, you know, in December or something, just depending on what the growth was. I wouldn't turn them out here now because they'd be through this in about a week, and, you know, then it'd take it forever to recover. But if I had some good winter grass growing out here, that might just be another way that I could save some hay. So it's something to think about. We'll see. So every time I do the updates, I try to get a shot from right here, just standing in the corner of the pasture, and this is what we're looking at. All right, guys, so what's the verdict on the second update of the aerated pasture? Well, I can't say that there's a huge difference out here, honestly. I want to. What I can say is that I see some things happening out here that kind of suggest a positive trend is coming. Basically,
what I'm seeing out here has got me hopeful for the future, but as of right now, today, January 31st, not a huge change out here. We've got some grass coming up, but there's really not a significant difference between the treated checks and the untreated checks. But I think something's happening here. I see some good signs, so we're just gonna have to keep watching this. I'll be back out here in another month. We'll just do it at the first of the month. So at, that'll be March 1st already. Time's flying. Anyway, by March 1st, I'm hoping we'll start to see some things happening out here. And as the weather really warms up and grass starts taking off, I might do bi-weekly updates if there's stuff to show. I mean, if nothing's happening, we're not gonna do that. But so anyway, I'm hopeful. I think stuff's starting to happen out here, but still too soon to call it victory. Thanks for hanging out with me in the field today, guys, and I hope I'll see you again on Farmer Tyler Ranch.